Welcome you all to today's modular classroom. Today we are going to see the settings of Open Broadcaster Software OBS. When we go for streaming the video, uploading either to Facebook, YouTube or some other games, we have to go for OBS that we have seen in detail in last video of how to go for a live stream in OBS. If you have not seen that, you can go back and look into the video of going for a live streaming in YouTube. In that, there are many settings which help you to go for a smooth streaming. So here in the, you should click on the settings, and once you click the settings, you will be taken to the settings tab. Here in the, there are a lot of options: general, stream, output, audio, video, hotkeys and advanced. So the main settings are the general settings. Here generally we have to look into the general informations, what is the language, what is the theme, and in the output, if you want to check these confirmation, show confirmation dialog when starting streams. So when you once click start streaming, if this is enabled, it will give us the confirmation message, or else it is not checked, so I don't give any message, it will immediately start streaming the data. Show configuration dialog, show confirmation dialog, automatically record when streaming. There is also a start recording option here. We'll look into this at right at bottom right corner. Here we have start streaming, start recording, studio mode settings. So once you give start recording, it will be recording you separately. But you want both streaming and recording. If this tab is enabled, these both options will be done. So you will also have the recorded copy in your own personal login in your desktop. If it is not given, the recorded version will not be available. Only live stream will be happening. Then automatically, this is what we have seen. Then keep recording when stream stops. Once the stream stops, the recording content will be available. Automatically start replay buffer when streaming. Keep replay buffer active when the stream stops. So these are some of the general and output options in the general settings. And when you go to the stream, this is where we have to copy the stream key of the live content. And output, we have to go for encoder, rescale output, rate control, keyframe interval, CPU usage presetter, profile, tune, X264 options. So here we have, there are many inside, there is many options, output mode, then streaming. This settings is for streaming. Then you click on recording, the settings changes for recording. You can do both the contents, both the things in OBS. You can do streaming and also recording. Then the separate settings for audio, what is the bitrate of audio, and bitrate of video will be sitting in the video here. Then replay buffer, enable the replay buffer. If it is enabled, it will replay. Then streaming, there are encoder, Quicksend Core, X264, two options. Then rate control, if you have a high bit data, you can go for higher versions, CRF, very bandwidth, VBR, ABR, etc. If you have low bandwidth, you can select CBR. Then what is the bit rate of data transfer? The how much bit you have to go for a speed test before going for a live stream, only then you will be able to give this bit rate. Then keyframe interval, seconds. Then CPU usage, how much how fast you are going to use the CPU, either it is ultra fast, super fast or very fast. So this setting can be selected here. And next setting is audio. So audio, nothing much we want to change. Sample rate channel something. Then video, here we have to go for, this is the base resolution, 1920x1080, and output resolution you have to give. So what is the output scaling ratio, whether you want a HD effect or something. If you give high resolution, the video output quality will be very high, but also note that you should have a high bandwidth of data. Assume there are 1000 people, you are working in a networked team of 1000 people, and if 1000 people are sharing the network, your bandwidth will automatically reduce. And also if you are using your Wi-Fi for connecting, you won't get much bandwidth. So depending on the bandwidth, you should select the output resolution in the video content. So if it is something somewhere medium, you can go for some 648 or 720. If it is very low, you should go for 432 or 398. If it is very high bandwidth, you can go for 1080. And downscale filter, bilinear, fastest, but blurry if scaling. So here also, there are three options. Download filter, there are three options: bilinear, area, bicubic, lens cost. So fastest option, weighted and sharpened scaling will take high bandwidth. If you have low bandwidth, you can go for lens cost or bilinear. So depending on the bandwidth, we can decide the video content and the output content. These two plays a very important step, especially the bitrate. The bitrate is very important, and in video we have to select on the resolution. So resolution and output resolution and video content and the output bitrate are the two important factors which helps us to live stream your video content either in YouTube or in Facebook. But these two factors help us in a smooth streaming. So you can go for some hotkeys in advanced version, and once you can click apply and OK, it will be saved. Here you can give start recording and stop recording. So these are the settings enabled with the OBS, Open Broadcaster software. Thank you. Stay tuned. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe. Stay tuned for further updates.